Hey everyone, this is Intentionally Unintentional ASMR, back with another video. Today I thought I'd do a little bird watching in the backyard, identifying some birds. Hopefully you can see there's a chickadee on the feeder right now. Those guys like suet nuts and all that. Hope you can see them. Let me see if I can zoom in anymore. There we go. So that's a chestnut-backed chickadee. I've actually got a family living in the birdhouse I have outside my window right now. But hopefully we're gonna get some cool birds. I've got this book with me here. And maybe I'll be able to show you guys some of the birds we're seeing. I've also got a drink with me. Got a little kombucha. Hear a little rustling in the bushes. Let's see if I can get this more centered. There we go. Let's see if I can find our little friend, the chickadee. They're very small, but they're one of my favorite birds. I put some mealworms in my window feeder, which are kind of like dried worms, essentially. Chickadees really like those. They really like suet as well. Suet is just fat and seeds mixed together into like a little brick, and they put it in a cage and hang it from a tree, and they will cling onto the cage and eat from it. Having trouble finding the chickadee in here. There he is. Is that the right one? I think it's a chestnut-backed chickadee, but I'm not seeing that specific bird in here. So here's the closest thing to it. Something like that. So that's what was just on the feeder there. Hopefully we get some more. I've got a Synergy California citrus today. Good stuff. Mix it around a little bit, get the probiotics off the bottom. It usually gets pretty active around this time. It's I want to say 6:30 right now. Sun goes down around here around 7:45. Maybe I should have come out a little later, but I can always edit this video and, you know, just have the good parts in it. But it might be nice just to sit out here for like 30-45 minutes and see what we can get. Oh, that's good. That's good stuff. So, we get a fair amount of birds in my backyard. My mom and I have marked the pages in here of birds that we get. We don't see this guy too often, but we definitely see him. This plain titmouse. Get a lot of these. These are one of my favorites. The California towhee. This guy right here. Who's the feeder right now? That's another chickadee. That's the homie. They make a really cute, squeaky sound. But that towhee I was just showing you, they do this interesting thing where they'll hop back and forth with their feet on the ground to like dig things up that are under the soil. But it looks like they're just hopping around. Let's see, what else did we get? Another one of my favorites, the black phoebe. Right here. Haven't seen one of those in a while. I think they're more winter birds around here. Watched any of my other videos, you know I get these a lot at the feeder on my window. A little house finch. And they go crazy for those black oil sunflower seeds I have. I really enjoy sitting out here. Very good vibes usually. Hopefully you can see that little dove over there. That's another one of the common ones we'll get over here a lot. I don't think you can see him, but he'll, you can hear him. Hopefully it'll come into view under the feeder here. Or I can just pick it up and show you. There they are. Two of them. It's a morning dove. If you can hear that call, that was one of them. I'm sure you've heard a call like it. It's almost like a low-pitched whistle. They make an interesting sound when they fly away from something. It's almost like a warning. I'd say you can see the feeder pretty well. It looks like they're strolling on over to it. Here he comes. Come on, little guy. There he is. Let's see if we can find him in here. Yep, there he is. Oh, come on. Focus for me, would you? There he is. It's funny, they really fluff up when they get cold. And we've got some rocks back here that, you know, are in the sun all day, and then when the sun goes down, some of them sometimes will sit on the rock and fluff up to try and stay warm, and they all just gather on the rock. It's really cute. As you can see, they're just hanging out down there. They usually are in twos. They're very, I don't know what the word is, maybe dependent, but it's always two birds. I don't know if you can see in great detail, but that one that's closer to us is definitely the female. You can tell because it's a little lighter and it's got a thicker neck area. She also looks kind of thick right now, I'm not gonna lie, so she's probably carrying her egg still. They're definitely the most skittish of the birds. Oh, you can see her fluffing up down there. They're definitely the most skittish of the birds we get back here. You know, you open the door and they'll fly away almost immediately. We get squirrels and bunnies sometimes too, but they kind of sit under the feeder and just nibble away. What's interesting though is that the birds don't really mind having the squirrel down there. The only animals that'll drive away the birds are other birds, those being scrub jays and crows. Other birds really don't like those two birds. I'm a big fan of the scrub jays. I just think they're really cool looking, and they hop around, and they also like the suet, like the chickadees do, but unlike the chickadees, who can just kind of hang from the cage and grab what they want, the scrub jays are a little too heavy for the cage, so they have to kind of like flap their wings to stay hovering next to it and then peck at it while they're hovering. It's kind of interesting. Yeah, let's zoom out a little bit here. Angle the camera. Zoom out. Focus on the fence. A little more light. There we go. Come on, birdies. We are quite excited though, because in the birdhouse here in the backyard, we've got a couple of western bluebirds making their nest in there. We've been trying to get them to come to our yard forever, and you know, we tried putting food out that bluebirds like the mealworms, but nothing was bringing them over here. And what's funny is we got the birdhouse that's in the front yard specifically for the bluebirds. It was like advertised as a bluebird birdhouse. Like the hole was for them and all. And we put it up there, and we had chickadees in the one back here. But the bluebirds took over the one that's back here, and the chickadees resorted to using the one in the front yard. So both birdhouses are occupied. I can't really make a video about it just because it's hard to get footage of birds going in and out of the house. You have to be lucky to see it. But I'll definitely keep you updated as it progresses. The doves are still here. They're fluffed up right now. Hopefully we can get a good shot of them. you see what I'm saying? They're cold. They're trying to stay warm. They're very cute. Just posted. Now we just wait for some birds to show up. And they will come. Just They take a second. Sometimes when you're sitting out here, they don't want to come hang out. But most of the time, it's just absolutely nuts out here. Got all kinds of birds coming and going. Let's read about the morning dove, actually, because they're just hanging out. Description: soft sandy buff with a long pointed tail bordered with white black spots on wings. The low mournful, that's the sound, we know what that sounds like. They like open fields, parks, and lawns with many trees and shrubs. They breed from southeastern Alaska, Saskatchewan, Ontario, Quebec to New Brunswick, southward to Mexico and Panama. So they're everywhere. This abundant bird has increased with the cutting of forests and burning off of grass. The mourning dove is common in rural areas in all parts of the United States, as well as city parks and in winter suburban feeders. In some states it is hunted as a game bird, on others it is protected as a songbird. Its species name, Macrura, is Greek for long-tailed. The young are fed regurgitated, partially digested food known as pigeon milk. Gross. Still just hanging out down there, these guys. What's up, homies? Birdies, show us something here yet. Still waiting on, we've only gotten a chickadee and two doves. But we are hopeful for more. I might only be able to record like 5 or 10 more minutes. My battery's at like 10% here. So we need these boys to come through. I love how the doves are just sitting there. They went and ate, and now they're just posted up, hanging out. Enjoying the backyard. I've had a pretty lazy day today. Oh, we got a little finch on the rock. Hope he goes to the feeder. There he is. So that's the female house finch. The male is the red one that you may have seen in some of my other videos. We got another one down in the grass right in front of me. Let's see if I can angle the phone a little bit. There he is. There she is, I should say. So yeah, two female house finches. Come coming to get some grub. These are the ones that go crazy for that black oil sunflower seed. And it's interesting watching them at the window feeder. They obviously have been around for a very long time, and their beaks are just perfectly evolved for cracking those seeds and getting the stuff out of them real quickly. Okay, both of them are at the feeder now, and now just one. She was like, get out, that's the best spot. That's where all the seeds are. I was eating grass earlier. These ones, you know, you'll see them in pairs here and there, but not like doves. Doves are always together. It's very rare you see an odd number of doves. Sometimes we'll have up to like six beneath the feeder. I've counted, I think, 10 out here before. Here he comes again. Hopefully now more will start to come. Yeah, as I was saying, I've had a decently lazy day today. I got up around 9, went to the gym. Cleaners were at the house today, so I had to vacate for a little bit. But I got some work done on the company my buddy and I are working on. And been watching the Giants game. I'm a big baseball fan. So it's been a good day. Gotten some stuff done, got to relax a little bit. Now it's kind of a party at the feeder. We got two finches and two doves. I want some other birds to show up. Like I want a junco maybe to show up, and maybe a California towhee. Another bird that we get a lot, the rufous-sided towhee. I really like that one, and it's a very interesting looking bird, but they don't come out until, you know, later once the sun is like almost down or already down. Let's see how much battery we have left here. Alright, we're at 7%, so we're still good. While I've been out here, nobody's been to the suet either. Oh, here we go. Got some finches on top of the feeder now. Male and a female. There's the male, he's red, I don't know if you can tell. They're enjoying themselves, tossing seed about. Down in the bottom left there, that's a California towhee. See, now we're starting to get some birds. There's a junco. That's the California towhee down there. It just scared him all the way. Let's see if he does his little hop. Come on, little guy. It's a junco right next to him with the little black head. I'll pull up a photo of those guys. See, now we're starting to get somewhere. You can see the junco doing his little hop back and forth there. Or sorry, the towhee. Trying to dig stuff up. Let me find that. Here's the junco. He's right next to the towhee. this little guy. Another one of my favorites. There's a good view of one right there on the rock. Those guys are really cute. They're called Oregon juncos or hooded juncos. They look like they have a little hood on them. It was really sad a few years ago. One of them hit one of the windows at our house and died on the spot. And we didn't see juncos for like 6 or 7 months. Birds are pretty smart like that, you know. If they see one of their own in some danger, they won't, you know, go around that area much. So my little California towhee's still down there doing his little jump. We got two finches on the feeder right now. Still have our dove friend back there, and a junco right beneath the feeder. So now the action's picking up a little bit. Maybe we'll get a scrub jay visitor or another chickadee, but this is a pretty good picture of what we usually have going on back here. You know, no western bluebird, which we just started to get, no scrub jays, which are pretty common in the backyard. Chickadee already came. We'll get that rufous-sided towhee, but like I said, probably later in the day. What else? I think that about covers it for what we normally get. Not in the backyard, but sometimes in the trees near our house we'll get cedar waxwings or like goldfinches and yellow orioles. Little towhee's coming back. You see what I'm saying? How they just move around like they're just frantic all the time. It's hilarious. See, you still got two finches on the feeder. The sounds from outside, you know, like the natural ambient sounds, are relaxing and not disruptive. Like you may hear the wind chimes or the cars on the road over plains or the wind, but I hope that kind of adds to the effect of this video, what I was trying to accomplish there, you know, just kind of being natural ASMR. Intentionally unintentional, if you will. Man, I love that little towhee down there. Well, I got another female finch that just landed on the top, the hook on the feeder. She'll drop down here in a sec. Come on, sweetheart. There she is. I like to think that these birds know me, but they have no idea who I am. They're probably still scared of me, even though I would never, ever hurt one of them. Birds are easily my favorite animal, just because, one, they can fly, which is awesome, but I just think they're so interesting, and see, there's the scrub jay. what was I saying about how he just scares them all away when he comes through? Let's see if I can get him. He's on the suet. All that for nothing. He didn't even get any suet. Okay, birdies, it's okay to come back. But as I was saying, they're interesting because there's so many different types, and that's a testament to how well they've been able to evolve. Like, all these different birds have, you know, different structures of body and beak and, you know, claw that have, you know, evolved to allow them to succeed in their respective environments. And I just think that's so cool. There's so many different varieties. And that's true for any species, but I feel like there's so many birds. You know, each of them, I wouldn't say they're like at the top of their food chains, but I mean, things like raptors, or raptor-like birds like eagles, hawks, falcons, owls, they're at the top of their food chains for sure, but these other birds don't really get hunted by much. They kind of just live their lives and eat seed and insects and worms. I really